I talk about Kanye West going to the Trump White House tomorrow, which is Thursday, October 11, 2018, and the reaction he has gotten from CNN, more specifically Don Lemon, Bakari Sellers, and a couple of other individuals. Now, I do have video of their particular reaction. I won't play the whole thing, but if you want to see the whole thing, I'll put that in the box. In this video, you'll see how dismissive they are of Kanye West, disrespectful, and really racist. The left always claims to be the quote-unquote anti-racist, the anti-sexist, is that, and a third. Meanwhile, if you disagree with them, if your point of view slightly differs from theirs, then they'll engage in racism, sexism, so on and so forth. So what I'm going to do right now is go ahead and roll the clip. After we get done with the clip, I'll talk about what was said, and I'll talk about this general sentiment towards anybody who is a black conservative. So without further ado, let's go ahead and roll it.
Bakari, do you think Trump is just using Kanye as a prop to win over black voters before the midterms?
I'm not sure he's using him as a prop per se, but what Kanye West has done with Donald Trump is what other people have done who've gravitated into his orbit, which is just shower him with adulation. For what reason, I have no idea. But my issue with Kanye West is quite simple. It's that anti-intellectualism simply isn't cool. Kanye West is what happens when Negroes don't read. And we have this now, and now Donald Trump is going to use it and pervert it, and he's going to have somebody who can stand with him and take pictures.
Just looking at Scott's face. Scott's like, whoa, okay. So
it's a Chris Rock reference, by the way, Scott. go back and watch the old Chris Rock stand-ups from the 90s.
Maybe I will
look that up.
I know that. All right, listen, maybe it'll work, Tara. Will it? I don't know.
Work for who? It's not going to work in the black community. Listen, black folks are about to trade Kanye West in the racial draft, okay? They've had it with him. He's not the same Kanye.
Whoa. I do know that reference. I know that. Oh. That is an old Dave Chappelle skit. I know
there
that
you
one.
Go. And he's an attention whore like the president. He's all of a sudden now the model spokesperson. He's the token Negro of the Trump administration. This is ridiculous. And no one should be taking Kanye West seriously. He's clearly has issues. He's already been hospitalized.
All right. So you saw that. You see what's going on. Now, first things first, the racism is real. These people claim to be anti-racist, like I said, but they are anything but that. Very racist. Just because Kanye West happens to be black, that means he automatically must align with them. See, the way they talk about him is different than your average conservative. If it was a white male on there talking, they would just look at him as just, you know, typical white guy. This is just a normal thing. But because Kanye West is black and he thinks differently, he's not even really a conservative. He is more of a liberal still, but he has points of view that are different. He is not a lockstep kind of guy. He's not going to be the kind of person you could put into a box and say he must be this way or he must be that way. He's just himself. And he's always been that way since the very beginning. In 2005, like I've said in previous videos, he came out and said that George Bush does not care about black people during that Hurricane Katrina live, a telethon? I remember that. You had Mike Myers right next to him looking nervous. Chris Tucker, they panned to him. He looked real nervous. Kanye has been the same person since the beginning. He has not changed. But since his point of view is not popular right now, all of a sudden he's a bad guy. All of a sudden he's mentally ill. All of a sudden he's deranged. All of a sudden, you know, he's been hospitalized. He needs to go back. Put him on a medication. This, that, and the third. And I expect nothing less from a CNN, from your Don Lemons of the world, from your Bakari Sellers of the world, because these individuals, in my humble opinion, are there on television to be kind of gatekeepers of sorts, overseers. Stay right in your place, black man, black woman. If you're part of the LGBT, they link everybody that's not a quote-unquote white male in one big box. And you saw that guy that was on there. He was there, in my humble opinion, to be a dopey white guy so they could kind of make fun of him, have him be a prop. All while at the same time, they say that Kanye West is being used as a prop by Donald Trump. Trump has always been a friend to the black community for years and years, long before any kind of presidential aspirations. You see him in photos with Tupac, with Muhammad Ali, with a lot of different people. But all of a sudden now, he is still meeting with a lot of these relevant people, hip-hop artists, entertainers, business people, educators, medical professionals happen to be black, and all of a sudden he's using them for props. Well, why wasn't he using them for props before 2016 or 2015 when he announced he was going to run? Why all of a sudden now? It's simply because he's on the wrong side of things. You see, when Barack Obama would have parties at the White House with all these black entertainers and do photo ops, nobody said, oh, he's just having a photo op, which is exactly what it was. People would come to the White House and not even discuss anything. It would simply be a party. He'd have you perform for free for him. But where was the actual tangible things? Like, you have people like Bob Johnson, who is a multimillionaire by my estimation, and I think I'm pretty much correct when I say that, the former owner of BET. He met with Trump and he said on television, much to the chagrin of the white liberals that were there interviewing him, or at least that one guy that was there, the young guy. I'll put a link to that video I did about that particular situation in the box if you want to see it, but I digress. Bob Johnson was talking about how he would communicate very tangible things to Trump, and they would have conversation about that. It wasn't just, oh, come take this picture with me, come get in the photo op. That's what Obama did. People neglect that because Obama is on their side. If Trump was on the left, then nobody would say anything about Kanye West going to the White House. You could have the exact same type of rhetoric, but it doesn't even really matter. Barack Obama was more of a war hawk and a warmonger than Trump could ever be. But because Trump was on the wrong side of things, all of a sudden it's a bad situation. At the end of the day, as I close, I just want to say, Kanye West, I support you, boss. I don't agree with everything you say, but I appreciate your opinions. I appreciate your ability to have an open mind. That's what we all need right now in the country, is to think a little bit more independently. I am a conservative, yes, and I pretty much align myself with that just because that's how I was raised, but I'm not going to be locked up with every single thing that a particular person who was popular in the conservative movement says or does, because at the end of the day, we are all individuals. Yes, we have a lot of things in common, but we are not the exact same. We are not clones of each other. On the left, they seem to not understand that. They want you to be a clone. They want you to stay on the plantation. They want you to be robotic like a machine. Now, as long as you adhere to all the core tenets, they'll give you freedom within that situation. But to me, what that sounds like is, as long as you stay on the plantation and don't escape the wall, don't scale the fence, don't go cross that gun line, then you'll be just fine. So what do you think? Do you think that CNN is doing what CNN does, shaming people because of who they want to meet with, because of their ideas, because they think differently? How do you feel about Don Lemon and his panel? Don Lemon, ashamed, on there laughing about jokes, you know, talking about all these white folks are clapping for Kanye West now because of how he is. Meanwhile, he's dating white men. I mean, the hypocrisy is really real. Bakari Sellers dating a basketball wife that's like 8 years older than him. That's fine. We don't want to talk about that. We just want to talk about Kanye West being this sick individual that needs to go back into the hospital and get on his medication because he dared to think differently, although he has been the exact same way since the very beginning. And no talk of him needing to be on medication and having some kind of mental breakdown ever really came about up until recently. But whatever your comments are, please let me know in the comments below.